I'm Gabriel Benjamin, and today we are going to do a brief restoration segment. Now, this is a little bit of stretching, but mostly just a lot of deep relaxation and breathing emphasis, and we're going to do it mostly laying down, so make sure your mat is soft, or do it with extra padding underneath. This is a good session for carpet, if you have carpet versus hardwood. And it's just a good session for anyone who feels stressed, burnt out, or if you are like a high-level athlete who's just done a lot of training, then this is going to be a very good recuperation session. So we'll actually begin laying down. So when you have everything you need, let's go ahead and lay down. And just take 5 deep breaths laying down. If you have back pain, you can have the knees bent, but otherwise have the legs lengthened and the arms lengthened and a little bit open, and continue breathing a little bit deeper each round. Taking some time to connect to your breath, bring the legs together and bend the right knee. Open the knee to stretch out in the hip. And if you'd like, open the arms overhead, taking about 10 deep breaths here. Inhaling till you're full and exhaling till you feel nice and empty. Your knee is in pain, you can have something under your thigh. Otherwise, letting gravity open the knee and hip for you is a good thing as we continue just to sink deep into the pose and deep into the breath. And when you're nice and complete with that stretch, go ahead and bring the right knee into the chest. And roll out your ankle really smooth. Both directions. the other side. Tree pose on the opposite side, option to arrange the arms overhead, or place them anywhere that feels really, really good for you. And take about 10 long, slow, deep breaths. Go ahead and lift the left knee, take one knee to chest, and roll out the ankle. Both directions. And just pause with the knee to chest. And release. And next we're going to extend one arm overhead and gently roll to the side and switch to laying down, face down. And briefly take the arms overhead to stretch out in all directions, and relax. And take the left arm under the head, reach back if you can, stretch the right thigh, and enjoy half frog stretch. Five deep breaths. Let's go ahead and switch the sides.
nice and complete with both sides. Have the hands alongside the hips. And rotate the head to the right until the ear is on the ground. And let the neck just naturally stretch with the leverage of the floor. Deep breath. Feel your body relax and your back muscles and glutes and legs. And continue to enjoy the floor supported stretch. Other side, relax, stretch, and breathe. After a little bit of time here, let's go ahead and readjust and take child's pose with knees wide. You can even fold your arms under your head unless the head effortlessly lays on the ground. Just rest here, enjoy the subtle stretches, and notice how they gradually get deeper as we hold. Breathing. Let's go ahead and adjust up and have one leg bent, the other leg forward, lift your chest and twist to the bent leg. If it feels good, go deep, but otherwise just enjoy stretching and breathing. You don't have to go really far to get a lot of relaxation out of the sequence. And we'll come back to center, stretch forward. If you don't feel good holding your foot, just hold the leg. Try to not round the back too much. A little bit's fine, but mostly lean forward through the chest, but do lower the head so you're relaxing your mind, slowing down the thoughts, and increasing the length and volume of the breath. Switch sides. Let's go ahead and release that stretch. Bend the other leg in. First, take a moment to sit up really tall and take a nice twist to the right and open the shoulders, open the chest. Turn the head if it feels good, but if not, just look forward or neutral. Deep breath. We'll do a nice forward bend. Remember to hold the leg. You could also have a bent knee. Hold the foot if it feels good, but we don't need to achieve anything here. Just relaxing, aiming to calm the mind and enjoy deep breathing. Soften the shoulders, reach forward through the chest a bit, head neutral or lowered, calming the mind with each exhale. That stretch, we'll come on up, and next we're going to do a little sequence at the wall to conclude. So make sure you have some wall space. Wider is good if you have that available, but just enough to put the legs up at very least. Take your time, readjust your cushioning if you need. Bring your hips against the wall, gently lay down, pivot, and invert the legs into a nice wall stretch. This will stretch your hamstrings a little bit. So if you feel tight, you can have your hips further back. You can also have the knees a little bent. But if you're able to have your hips flush with the wall and the legs straight up, it's a nice stretch and it's very rejuvenative to the legs and lower back as well. After a few deep breaths like this, go ahead and bend the right leg and take the ankle to the thigh and keep the ankle a little bit flexed. Start to bend the left leg and use your arm to push the knee away so you get a deep stretch into your glute for the wall-supported cradle stretch. The hips might lift up, that's okay, but eventually you work them down more and that helps you to go deeper. Most importantly, breathe deep. Let the physical achievements come as a byproduct of the breath. Extend the legs and take the other side. Stretch nice and deep into that glute. Breathe. Exhale slowly. Feel nice and complete, release, and then bend both knees, open the arms a bit, take the legs to the left. If your feet don't come to the floor comfortably, you can scoot away from the wall a tad. Otherwise, enjoy this, possibly put your hand on your thigh for leverage, and keep the right shoulder down. let's go ahead and adjust. Take the second side. If you notice you feel stiff a little bit more on one side, go into it slower, hold it a little longer. You're always welcome to pause the video and do extra on one side of a stretch if your body needs. Otherwise, we're going to take about 5 deep breaths. Back to center. Elevate the legs, and then if you have the space, open the legs into a nice V. If you can't open or your wall is too small, you could optionally do a squat. Otherwise, you can have the nice wide V and gradually go a little bit deeper as we hold. Stretching the hips, but also enjoying the inversion of blood from the legs and keeping the back nice and flat. Long neck, low shoulders. Arrange the arms in a way that feels really relaxing and soothing. Sometimes it feels good to breathe into your hands. We'll switch back to putting the legs vertical up the wall, and we're going to do this as our deep relaxation pose. So do this for at least a minute or two, and if you want to do it for longer than what I instruct, then feel free. Close the eyes, focus on the breath, let the legs feel lighter and lighter, the low back feels free, the spine is naturally lengthened along the earth. Enjoying all that support of the weight between the wall and the floor. Taking time to soften the breath and soften the body and soften the mind. course, you can hold longer if you like, but if that feels like it's been enough time, we're going to conclude our sequence today. So we'll just slowly come out of the position of the wall, do a little closing seat, and just take a moment to really appreciate that you took time to restore yourself and feel rejuvenated. Thank you all very much. Namaste. Again, my name is Gabriel Benjamin. I have a variety of different themes of classes, lots of different yoga and core conditioning, which is non-yoga, but has some stretching as well. So keep tuning in. All classes accept donation, but essentially they're free. So share with your friends if you can't send a donation, and all is appreciated. I'll see you again. And looking forward to creating more content.